Good morning, all of you. So let me start the today's session. So we are continuing with the module 4. So basically, we have gone through basic concepts of 3D weaving in last two sessions. We have gone through what is 3D weaving, what all the basic concepts being that is being involved in 3D weaving, and also what is a 3D weaving pipeline. So basic, one of the examination question was explain 3D weaving pipelines. You need to explain the diagram. And also we have gone with what is 3D weaving coordinate parameters, right? That is transformation from the world to view coordinates. What is projection and orthogonal, that we are going to see it today. Okay. So this is a 3D weaving pipeline that we have gone through in the last class. So the PPT has been arranged as per the syllabus, right? So we have a 3D viewing pipeline, how exactly the model view transformations are being transformed to viewing transformations, again from the viewing to projection, projection to normalized, and finally we have a from normalized to the viewport transformations. So in fact, this diagram is a general three-dimensional information pipeline. So if at all the question is explain the three-dimensional viewing pipeline, you should be in a position to explain this with the help of the diagram. And also there are three-dimensional weaving coordinate parameters. So this I had explained you how do you use a left hand thumb rule or right hand thumb rule to analyze the three-dimensional weaving along x-axis, y-axis and z-axis. So we have many 3D weaving coordinate parameters. So this I had explained in general because it consists of a lot of the concepts related to the normal values unit vector axis vectors and many concepts of right-handed weaving coordinate systems. So I don't think this could be an important topic, but for examination 6, we could remember what are all the three-dimensional weaving coordinate parameters, right? So 3D weaving coordinate parameters, how does the view plane looks like? So all these things I had explained. So next, the important concepts, today's concept is, so we have to go with the transformations from world to view weaving coordinates, okay? So this is a concept. So here is a concept. Today we'll let us start with the transformation from world to weaving coordinators. Usually what happens is in the three-dimensional weaving pipeline, the first step after a scene has been constructed, we need to transfer the object description to the weaving coordinates. Okay, weaving coordinates. So this conversion of the object is equivalent to the sequence of transformations. As you know, what is the meaning of sequence of transformations? The sequence of transformations consists of various, imposing a weaving reference frame on the word frame. So this could be accomplished using the method of transforming between the coordinate systems. So what are the steps for the coordinate systems? First is we need to translate the weaving coordinate origin to the original coordinate systems. Okay. First step is, so we need to, one second, let all the people join. Okay, see here. So this is the concept. How do you perform the transformation from world to weaving coordinates? So here is the major thing that you need to, that you want to simulate an animation planning effect. That is when a camera moves through a scene of the follows, object is moving through a scene. Okay. So we can see, we can keep the direction for n fixed as we move the viewpoint as in figure. So this is a theoretical part. And to display the different views of an object such as side view and front view, we could move the viewport around the object as in figure. So we are just moving the view code along the north in this direction, along this direction, and this is a reference point. So this is how do we generate a display the different views using a viewport. So generating also the alternately that there are different views of an object or group of objects that can be generated using geometric transformations. So I said there are two major steps, right, in modeling. That is, instead of moving the camera with the viewing transformations, we could have moved the cube away from the, this is called a perspective transformations, and also with the modeling transformations, this would be done. So this was the point that I was explaining you. That is, in the three-dimensional weaving, the first step after a scene has been constructed, a transfer object description. That is, we need to transfer object description to the weaving coordinate system frames, right? So we can do the we could accomplish this conversion using method of transforming between the coordinate systems. How it could be achieved? This is achieved by the translate the weaving coordinate origin to the origin of the world coordinate systems. So this, you know, this concepts, you know it. How do you perform a translation? Then apply rotation to the LN XY, YV and ZY. This also you have understood. So this is along X axis, this is along Y axis, and this is along the Z axis rotation. Once again, weaving coordinates is a world position. P is 0 equal to x naught, y naught, z naught. Therefore, the matrix of the translating the weaving origin to the origin is given this. And for the rotation matrix, we can use a unit vector u, v, and n to form or to accomplish rotation matrix that could impose the weaving axis onto the world frame. This transformation matrix is called as a rotation matrix. So we could specify finally if you could see the coordinate transformation matrix is then obtained as the product of the preceding translation rotation matrix. When you perform translation rotation multiplication, so you are going to get this. Hence, this is a translation factors are negative directions of point of observation P0. So the translation factors in this matrix is calculated as the vector product of each u, v and n unit vector with respect to the P0, which represents the vector from world origin to the weaving origin. Okay. So next is the projection transformations. What are projection transformations? So we have three transformations: projection transformations, orthogonal projection transformations, and what is that? Oblique transformations. So projection transformations basically specifies the projection, like choosing a lens of a camera, right? So in projection transformation, the coordinates are transferred to the view plane along the parallel lines. This you have to remember very carefully. So how does this is, we have a parallel lens. So how does it looks like? See here, all of you. So this is a P1, P2, P1 dash, P2 double dash. So if you could see figure, this figure illustrates a parallel projections for a straight line segment defined with endpoints coordinates, that is P1 and P2. A parallel projection preserves relative proportions of the object, and this is a method that is being used to design or produce various three-dimensional objects. So all parallel lines in a scene are displayed as parallel when viewed and parallel as a parallel projection. So there are two general methods for obtaining a parallel projection view. That is, we can obtain along the lines that are perpendicular to the view plane, or we can project the oblique angle. Okay, so for example, for a perspective projection, object positions are transformed to the projection coordinates along the lines that converge to a point behind the view plane. So both projections I had explained here, the parallel and perspective. An example of perspective projection for a straight line segment defined with the endpoint P1 and P2 is shown in this figure. You could see here P1 dash, P2 double dash. This is a convergence point. Unlike a parallel projection, a perspective projection does not preserve relative proportions of the objects. So, but perspective views of our scenes are morely realistic, because distance object in the projected display are reduced in size. Try to understand the major difference between the parallel and perspective projections. So perspective projection uses a convergence point, whereas the parallel projection doesn't use the convergence point. So this could be demonstrated with the help of a cube perspective projection in the lab program. Perspective views of a scene are more realistic because distant objects in the projected display are reduced in the size. This is all about the parallel projection. Got it? This is all about the parallel projection. So explain projection transformations. So projection transformations consist of two types of transformations: parallel projections, perspective projections. Right? Understand? Projection transformations, we have two types. So we have one is parallel projection. Explain, the question could be explain projection transformation. So you have two types of projection transformations. One is a parallel and we have a perspective projections. Right? So next, let us go to the, so there are many other projection transformations. So that is a orthogonal projection. What is orthogonal projection? So let us go with the orthogonal projection. So you have understood this perspective projection. So let us go with the orthographic projection. A transformation of an object that describes the view plane along the lines are parallel to the view plane. It's called orthographic. So orthographic means that the object directly onto the screen without affecting their relative size. The size is not going to be varied in the case of orthographic projection. That is, transformation of object to a view plane along the lines are parallel to the view plane, and we are not going to change the size of the object. It is like an equivalently class. So this produces a parallel projection transformation in which the projection lines are perpendicular to the view plane. So basically, in the case of orthogonal projection, are used to produce front side and top views of an object. So as we could see in this figure, if you could see the front elevation, side elevation, so you could see, so the size is not going to be varied, all are perpendicular to the view plane. So in the case of orthogonal projection, projection lines are perpendicular to the view plane, right? As you could see in the figure, the front, side and the rear orthogonal projection of objects are called as elevations. This is called elevations, and top orthogonal projection is called a plane view. So this is one type of projection called orthogonal. Under orthogonal projections, we have gone through this diagram. Next, one more projection is there, axonometric. See, this comes orthogonal projection. Under orthogonal projection, there are different types of projections: orthographic projection, axonometric projection, isometric, right? So axonometric, basically it is a projection display more than one face of an object. So it is called axonometric. So you could see the diagram. Let us go with the diagram. So isometric projection is obtained by aligning the projection plane to the object. So explain projection transformations. There are two types of projection transformations: parallel, perspective. Explain orthographic projection. So orthographic projection consists of orthographic, axonometric and isometric projections. Three projections you have to explain. So this is all about orthogonal projection coordinates. Still lot many topics. So next is a clipping window. I'm just reviewing with, so I'll display the PPT. So lot many things we have to be go through, and I am stressing only on those topics which are quite relevant to the examination. Isometrics is over. So this is about the theory about orthogonal projection coordinates. So next, clipping window and orthogonal projection. So if you could consider the analogy of the camera for computer graphics application, we use a rectangular clipping window. Is it or not? We use a rectangular clipping window for this computer graphics. Basically, in two-dimensional weaving, graphics packages typically requires the clipping rectangle. But in OpenGL, we set up a clipping window for three-dimensional weaving, just as we did in two-dimensional weaving. That is by choosing the two-dimensional coordinates positions. That is at the lower left and upper right corner. Lower left and upper right corner. For three-dimensional weaving, the clipping window is positioned on the view plane with the edge parallel to the XV, YV axis. As you could see on the figure, right? The view plane of the clipping window, right? It is as you could see in this figure, for three-dimensional view, the clipping window is positioned on the view plane with its edge parallel to the XV, YV. So this is parallel to the XV, YV axis. See, is it not the parallel? Is it not parallel? So to the XV, it is to the YV, it is parallel. Once again, in the three-dimensional view, the clipping window is positioned on the view plane with edges, parallel to the XV and YV. So as you could see, XY, YV are parallel to this XW mean this edges. So this is parallel to this, this is parallel to this. The edges of the clipping window here specify the XY and Y limits for the part of the scene. Okay. So these are all the clipping window and orthogonal projection weaving volume. Also, this diagram shows one of the concept of orthogonal projection view. The projection lines are perpendicular to the view plane. These four boundaries, all of you see, all these four boundaries are planes that are also perpendicular to the view plane, and it passes through the edges of the clipping window to form an infinite clipping region. So to form an infinite clipping region. So this is a theoretical concept based on the concept of how do you clip the window and the orthogonal projection weaving volume. So many things, normalization transformation for the orthogonal projection. So basic topic is orthogonal projection. Once again, just before we end, what is orthogonal projection? Here I started orthographic projection. So we have basic classifications. So this is a topic. Projection transformations. Here we have parallel and perspective. Next we have orthogonal projection. We have what is orthographic, what is axonometric, and what is isometric, and explain. Then clipping window. Clipping window and orthogonal projection. Clipping window and orthogonal projection weaving volume consists of the few of the parameters. This parameters I had explained. So this vertical line of the view plane, that is XW max, YW max, this is parallel to the YV, and this is parallel to the XV, that is edges of the clipping window. And this diagram represents projection lines which are perpendicular to the view plane, and the boundaries are of the planes are also perpendicular to the view plane that pass through the edges of the clipping window. Similarly, moving further, normalization. So let me explain normalized transformation for orthogonal projection. So using orthogonal transfer of coordinate positions onto the view plane. So you hope you know what is orthogonal by this time. So we obtain the projection positions of any spatial input that is given xyz as xy. So once we have established the limits of the view volume, the coordinate descriptions inside the rectangular parallel are projection coordinates, and they can be mapped with the normalized view volume. That is without any further projection processing. The figure, this figure shows these screen coordinates that are often specified in the left-hand reference frame. Normalized coordinates are also specified in the left-handed system. That is a thumb rule. So this allows the positive distance in the viewing direction, that is the z-axis direction, the front is nearby is a positive direction, backside are the negative direction. The positive distances in the viewing direction is to be directly interpreted at the distance from the scene. Hence here we can convert the projection coordinates into the normalized coordinate reference frame, and these coordinate positions will be transferred to the left hand screen coordinates by the viewport transformations. So we have one of the mathematically concept that you need to remember, that is to illustrate the normalized transformations, we assume that the orthogonal projection is mapped into the symmetric normalization. This is here. So symmetric normalized cube with a left-handed reference frame. Left-hand reference frame means this is a left-hand reference frame, x-axis, y-axis, z-axis. So the z coordinate positions represents the near and far planes as denoted by z near and z far. Okay. Finally, transforming the rectangular pipeline view volume, that is this transforming the rectangular parallel pipe volume to the normalized cube is similar to the method of converting the clipping window into the normalized symmetric square. So here is a main thing. This you have to remember to explain the final concept of clipping window and orthogonal projection view volume. So the question was being asked for a 10 mark, explain orthogonal projection. So when it has been asked, orthogonal projection consists of orthographic, axonometric, isometric, and what are the normalized transformations and the orthogonal projection view volume. So all these things you have to explain. Till here you have to explain. So other projections we have oblique. So I don't think we have a, for a syllabus we have oblique projections, right? We have specific, we have perspective projection, separate topic. Okay, perspective projection separately we have. So this we will see next, and by that time maybe you know that is a complete coverage. Today we have seen 3D viewing coordinate parameters, transforming from world to viewing coordinates, what are projection transformations, what are orthographic projections, this we have seen. So left with perspective and some of the other concepts that could be completed in next, and then next week we would start with the fifth module, input interaction. So this only this much part will be covered by the Edward Angel part. Okay, so we left with the perspective projection. Still more, let us see what we have. Perspective projection, and we have to see what is vanishing. This you all of you have gone through in the cube program, and the part 2 is about what is a depth buffer and all. So that covers one more. So in by the end of this week we would be covering this unit, and by next week we would start with the fifth module, that is from Edward Angel, input interaction. It is a theoretical theory. We have most of the concepts are theory, right? So let me stop the session today. Those who have not given the attendance can give the attendance in the chat session.